architecture plan for major design project that we shall be doing in second semester design student.
So, the lecture title is Site and Planning Analysis.
And also, we would be wanting to cover two site and planning analysis. We would be wanting to discuss passive design strategies also. So, that would be the lecture title. So, the duration we have for this plan, particular lecture plan, we have taken as 2 hours. So, we have worked out for 2 hours. The learning objective would be to understand the importance of site analysis in design from the perspective of client. So we can do site analysis for many variables, but in this particular lesson lecture we would be discussing about client analysis, and we want them to apply the knowledge that they have done in first and second semester
and analyze. So
it's not very in-depth analysis, but of course analysis. And then the learning content, how we are wanting to do the learning content is that we will begin the class with the sensitization.
Does it have sun facing or do you have sun in the west, or do you have sun in the afternoon or in the morning? So the students will ask, okay, which facing is your house? Do you have morning sun, or do you have evening sun, or do you have sun in the whole day? So some will say morning or some will say, so we will ask, okay, so how do you feel during summer, during winter, during different times of the day? So then a discussion will start on whether it is east facing or they don't get sun at all, north facing house or wherever they are staying. So they say it is very cold, or during winter Delhi is pretty cold, there is no part of the house getting sun. So this kind of discussion we will start off, and they will be sensitive to their own environment, and they will understand and connect the orientation of their home. Many homes may be plotted apartments or flats where you will have only one orientation. Many of them may have a house which will have openings on all sides. So then a discussion will start of how the sun moves and how the orientation affects the thermal comfort or the how the occupants feel inside the home. So this is how we plan to start a dialogue with them.
So yeah, this discussion about how they are feeling. They got 15 minutes in that hour, and then the discussion would move on to okay, what could have been done differently. You know, the whole notion of that if they are not, suppose their balcony is very cold in winters and they are not getting any sun, there is no thermal comfort. So, there will be some discussion on thermal comfort part, and then what could have been done differently. So somewhere now we are moving towards, of course many things could have been done differently, but we will be talking about orientation here. That building will be oriented a bit differently.
If the site had allowed,
and if the orientation would have been different, then how they could have achieved thermal comfort. And so after this, we would want to move on to a discussion on that if their house is not comfortable, then what do they do?
What do they make it comfortable? How do you make it comfortable? So then they come up with they have an air conditioner or cooler or this or that.
Radiator or whatever.
Yeah.
So discussion about this electrical energy consumption, though it will not be in so much detail,
but to sensitize them about how much energy you will be wasting and what are the without all this throwing of the, all these reference into the atmosphere, just general, not too much detail, but to just make it sensitive to the fact that by using air conditioner, community wastage is there and what other problems come up, all the gases and everything that comes out. So what else can be done without using these mechanical and electrical means? What about the passive means? What about what has been done? We can also actually before this they had also have a chapter on vernacular. So maybe in the past also we could link up. Earlier there were no ACs. So somewhere there, but that's what we were building up on.
So now we will move on to need of solar passive design. And in solar passive design, and within solar passive will have many dimensions to it. But in this particular lecture, we will be talking to them about orientation. How orientation can be used as a tool for solar passive design. And in this, the actual demonstration now I shall be discussing that we will be wanting them to get as a tool a small block model,
yeah,
a small tower torch.
So we have a model and we may have a solar path chart of the site, particular latitude and everything. So with the block model, we are going to show the sun movement through a torch and then day to day.
Actually, what I had thought was that first we will be discussing about what is the latitude and display of the site. Yeah. So they should learn to, again,
the sun path is the
revisiting this comes
as the altitude and the sun movement and then the site where the latitude is.
So whatever site they have taken in that sense, but they should find out the sun path diagram of that particular latitude, bring it to the class. There will be a basic discussion to begin with, 5 minutes discussion on sun path diagram and the site latitude. And then we can come to the
demonstration of this is an activity to show how the movement of the sun through the movement of the sun and the orientation of the building, we want to make them sensitive to the fact that how more heat will be collected and stored in the house, or less, how to make it lesser, and how the orientation and how the sun movement is operated. So this is being good for the summer months, and then we will invite the students to do it for the winter months. So the students have to come forward and work on this activity, showing us how the sun movement is the winter months and how this model will be effective.
So when we will do it for different months, so randomly we can choose which will also give them an opportunity to actually, we will also get an insight of whether they have actually understood this sun path diagram and do it, or further intervention is required in that also. So there will be a discussion on that, and then discussion culminating towards the importance of form and orientation. Why the longer side has to be,
whether the longer side is north-south oriented or east-west oriented, and how it affects the heat which is collected inside the house, how it can minimize and better orientation and form. How to use the form as the orientation. So coming on to that, then we
I think we will come to question and answer sessions. So a total time that we had in the workout is that initial sensitization 15 minutes, then mechanical energy versus electrical energy, consumption versus solar passive architecture around 15 minutes, and then site latitude and sun path diagram 5 minutes discussion, then demonstrate how sun will move, that demonstration by teacher about 15 minutes. Demonstration by students about 15 minutes, then form a discussion, you are reaching towards some kind of a conclusion, again 15 minutes, and then some time is left for question and answer about 15 minutes or so.
So we can also, towards the end, we always also add on what is going to be the next class, so then we are going to go on to the next one. Next topic would be wind movement. After we have summarized this question and answer,
so the learning activities that we will be doing will be demonstration, lectures, and discussion. There will be an assessment and evaluation also, because if the student is not able to pick week of the month and actually demonstrate how the sun will move. So that is some kind of an assessment evaluation on our part and also on their part. And the learning aids that could be used would be a small block model, sun path diagram, and a torch. And then learning outcomes, not fully I have written, but students will develop understanding of sight and planet analysis. Second is
importance of sight
analysis. And then student will learn to apply knowledge of sun path diagram in sight analysis and orientation of reading. Third will be student will learn to analyze, you know, that how form and orientation interlink at a very basic nascent stage hoga, because this is a second semester student, but we can slowly make it a more graded challenge as the semester progresses.